Okay, hello guys, welcome to the channel back. If you are new to this channel, please consider liking and subscribing to this channel. And also, if you have any questions and comments, you can write them down to me. Okay, thank you. Okay, today I'm gonna show you my new Slayer Exciter. It's not a rotating Slayer Exciter. It's made of 8 transistors. Here I have 8 transistors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 transistors. BD243C. They are all connected in a sequence. Each transistor has a base, a collector, and an emitter. All emitters are connected in a row here. All collectors are connected here. The collector pin goes to the one side of the primary coil, and on the base we have series and parallel sequences of resistors. So each transistor needs to get 2.2 kilo ohms of resistor. So when you connect two in parallel, then you cut the cut on half the resistance, but the total resistor, and here is the finishing point, needs to be 2.2 kilo ohms. So I have two in sequence, which gives 2.4, 4.4, 4.4, 2.2 kilo ohms, 4.4, 4.4, 2 in parallel gives 2.2 kilo ohms resistance. So you need to calculate the correct resistance to connect 8 BD243 transistors in parallel. And on the end I have two capacitors, 2000 kilovolts and 22 nanofarads, which are connected to the final resistor and to the emitter, or to the negative pin. So you can connect, as you can see, 8 BD243 NPN transistors, or even more, in parallel to get a multi-frequency Slayer Exciter. And this is my multi-frequency Slayer Exciter. As you can see, the height is my finger's distance. And also the problem is you have to adjust the primary coil, the turns. If the turns can't be too many, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 turns of the primary coil. On this side I have only 3 turns of primary coil, and 4th is on the base. To get this Slayer this is a multi-frequency Slayer Exciter. It's not rotating, but it's multi-frequency. Okay, now I'm gonna show you how this multi-frequency, multi-transistor Slayer Exciter works. I have connected the positive terminal to the positive end. That's one side of the primary coil, or that's collector, and negative goes to the emitter. This is this wire, or this sequence. Okay, let me just disconnect. Okay, I'm connecting the negative terminal. As you can see, it draws 0.7 amps and it's lighting. And the frequency is 20 kilohertz. Okay, let me just disconnect this. Okay, now I'm gonna try to scan this Tesla coil in megahertz range. First I need to connect the power. Okay, I'm connecting it in megahertz range, as we can see, it's 1.1 megahertz, and it's also emitting energy. Okay, I disconnect the power because I don't have appropriate heatsink. I had a problem on the top. I had to disconnect the top. I had to cut down the top because it burns this paper. Okay, I adjusted it. Okay, I'm gonna connect it again. The frequency is 120 kilohertz. Also, okay, I disconnected it. Okay, and I'm gonna connect it in a megahertz range. The frequency is 1.124 megahertz. Okay, I disconnected it. Okay, scan in anti megahertz range. Doesn't show anything. Okay, again scanning for in megahertz, 4 megahertz range, 1.125 megahertz, also emits power. Now scanning 1 megahertz range, it shows 127 kilohertz. And also emits energy. And now again scanning 100 kilohertz range, it shows 28.7 kilohertz. As you can see, it draws 0.7 amps. Okay, thank you for watching.
Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching and peace.